Alright, my friends, welcome back to my walkthrough for Final Fantasy XV.
Hello.
So, during this segment, we
Would
are
you like
going to
something to
be
eat?
completing a bunch of new
Recently,
side
these
quests,
beasts have been prowling
and
about.
I recommend that you do these side quests now. Yes, there will be a lot of them for us to solve, but I'm
Best
going
of
to
luck.
try and do them in the best order possible so that we don't have to travel back and forth a lot.
Do be careful.
But first things first, we're going to start with the hunt, which is close by. So drive to that area. And for this hunt we're going to be battling a bunch of bees, so remember, firearms really work well against them. And they're also weak against ice magic, so keep that in mind. But there's quite a few side quests that we can complete around this area, so we'll get them all done now. Of course, I'm going to be cutting out all of the traveling times between each area, because otherwise this video would probably be like 3 hours long, and that's too much. Even now I'm sure it's going to be very, very long, but anyway. We're going to move forward just a little bit. And let me just give Noctis
thanks, buddy.
The Blizzaga spell. I don't know why I keep doing this. Let's switch the daggers with the firearms just for now. And I might not even need Blizzaga actually, but... Or maybe I will. We'll see. But let's get up here. And yes, I am going to use Blizzaga, otherwise it will take forever to take care of all these dudes. And we're going to strike one of them, and then we're going to wait for them to be all close together before I cast Blizzaga on them. And that way, we'll be able to get rid of a bunch of them at the same time. There we go. I don't know how he managed to land a hit on me since I blocked, but whatever. Let's try this again, shall we? That one's down. But there's quite a lot of them here. There we go. Terry, shoot. Terry again, let's shoot. And let's use Igni's Enhancement.
Thanks.
Which will make this fight even easier.
What did you expect?
There we go.
Oh, hi there, opening.
And that's all of them. So that's it for this hunt. And like I said, we're going to be completing some more hunts along the way as well. Of course, we have to go back in order to accept a new hunt, but we'll accept a new hunt later. For now, we're going to complete another quest for Dino, or Dino, whatever you call him. And we're going to head towards that direction. We've been there before. That's where we saved one of the hunters in distress. But here we are, guys, and we're going to call our chocobo here. And make sure you have polearm equipped, because the enemies that we're going to battle, they're weak against polearm, so keep that in mind.
Let's go.
And we're going to move all the way and follow across the river. all the way almost to the edge of the map, and that's where we will be able to find the stone that we need. We're not going to go and deliver it now, but we'll just collect it now, and then once we travel back to Galvin Quay, because there will be other side quests for us to complete in that area later on, we will give the stone to Dino. So keep that in mind.
Overhead.
But for now, we're just going to keep running.
Beautiful day. Totally.
Almost there. And I recommend that you take a chocobo, because not only does it speed up the traveling time, but you can avoid all of the random battles. There's no point in fighting all of the enemies here. Here we are.
Thanks for the ride. Nice. Time to get our hands dirty.
Have your drain lance prepared. And we'll just strike away. There's a lot of them, but we'll manage. Again, Blizzaga works really well here. There we go. There we go. That was quick. And now the stone is right here on the ground, so turn around and pick it up.
All that's left is the delivery.
And like I said, we'll deliver it later, so don't worry about it now. But here is the location of the stone, make sure you memorize it. Again, it's almost in the edge of the map. So keep that in mind. And now we're going to travel right over here, because we're going to complete an optional tour. We'll have to get the flower for Iris. So travel towards that position right there, and I'll give you directions once we're there. Okay, so once you're here, guys, call your chocobo, and we're going to make a run for it.
Easy now.
And all that you need to do, you need to inspect, or you need to set up camp very close by at the Lambat Haven, I think that's what it's called. And in the morning, or before you go to bed actually, Gladio will come and talk to you, and he'll demand that Noctis helps him find a flower for Iris. And yeah, before we do that, let me just absorb some ice magic here. There we go. And now let's get a move on. So we'll set up camp.
Camping. Again.
Well, you got a problem with camping?
To be fair, this tour, to me, it's pretty wrong, in my opinion, because Gladio is inciting Noctis to give a flower to Iris. Clearly because Gladio understands that Iris has some sort of feelings for Noctis. But it seems that Gladio conveniently forgot that Noctis is about to get married. So I'm not even going to begin to explain why that's wrong. So either Gladio's being a terrible friend here, or I don't understand why they thought that this was okay. But it's nice to have our chocobos in our camp at least. Look at them eating away. All happy. What's up, bro?
They, knocked? I have a favor to ask. I want to do something for Iris, and I need your help.
What's this now?
Well, my sis puts on a brave face, but I know it's not easy for her. I just wanted to do something for her to show that I care. And that's where you come in. I hope.
Yeah, sure thing. So, what do you need me to do?
Pick a flower.
A flower?
A particular flower that only blooms at dawn, indigenous to these parts. Iris has always had a soft spot for him.
An early morning. Well, at least it'll be easy pickings. You can count on me.
Yeah, I can't wait for this quest, finding flowers. Well, why am I complaining? I completed the quest where I literally had to find a tomato, so... But anyway... And apparently her name is Iris, not Iris. I always call her Iris,
okay.
But...
Let's go pick that flower.
Just to check, you sure you
there's a treasure chest close by to the location of the flower, so we'll use that as a reference.
Alrighty. Here we are. Bound to be one around here somewhere.
It's a pretty big somewhere to look.
It'll feel great when you find it. Come on.
If I find it.
So we have to go through here. And at least we get 20 ability points for doing this, so I guess it's not a terrible reward, and it's one of those tours. The tours, you always get them done very quickly, so at least that's their benefit. And you don't have to travel back and forth nearly as much as in some other side quests, but either way, I do think this is completely wrong, because Noctis shouldn't be giving flowers to anyone aside from his future wife.
Noct, I see one. There.
And Gladio shouldn't be encouraging it.
How am I supposed to reach it?
Well, that's why I'm here. To give you a boost.
Alright, let's give it a shot.
You mean to tell me that Noctis, the guy who can essentially teleport from one place to the other, couldn't make the jump and needed Gladio's help here? I don't think so. Plus, Gladio apparently could climb on his own, so...
Yeah, we got it.
Great work, Noct. Couldn't have done it without you.
Not really sure you needed me.
Well, I'd like you to give her the flower. That'll mean even more to her.
Huh? Why? What's wrong with it being from us?
How clueless can you be? Look, just hand it to her for me, okay?
Nice job, Gladio. You're really doing
good hustle out there.
Both Iris and Noctis a lot of favors here.
I'm awesome.
See, the thing is, he's still encouraging his sister, or he's trying to have Noctis encourage his sister by having him give her flowers when he's getting married, so she has no chance with him. So there's a lot of ways that this entire tour was wrong, but yeah, he's not being a good brother, in my opinion. He should just try and find Iris some other person to date if she really wants that. But anyway, let's travel to another area. And we're going to complete another side quest. So here we just need to defeat a bunch of enemies, nothing special.
Wanna bash some heads in?
No, I'm in.
Ooh, head bashing!
And by the way, in order for the tour to be completed, you just have to pick up the flower. You don't actually have to go and give it to Iris, that nothing happens. So don't worry about it. But anyway, this is the location in which we need to be, and we'll probably be caught in... Yep, we're going to be caught in two fights, but that's okay. So let's just start striking away. These dudes have a lot of health, but with Igni's enhancement we should be okay. And we can always cast Blizzaga to speed up the fight if we really want to. There we go. And there's our target.
Get
nice little combination there. I do like it when they perform their link strikes.
Say your prayers.
There we go. And we're not going to head to Lestalem quite yet. Instead, we're going to go ahead and we'll get complete the aftermath of the Astral War side quest. So we need to take two pictures and you just need to follow the location on the map. Can't miss it because it's marked, like I said. So that's our traveling destination. We'll take a chocobo to reach it once we can't drive anymore. Okay guys, so let's get on our chocobo and let's start running towards the designated area. It's easier to do this on a chocobo because, like I said, you can avoid all of the random battles. I mean, if you really want to fight enemies here, you can, but I wouldn't really worry about it. And there's some items for us to pick up around here, but they're nothing special, so I would just let them be, honestly. But just like with the other quests relating Viv, we have to take two pictures from different locations. This is the first one, but as soon as you take the first picture, you will be told the location of the second area that you need to head to in order to get the picture. So these quests are all very basic. I don't expect anyone to really having issues with this one because it's not like you even have to find anything.
Is it famous?
But let's get on top of the tower, and that's where we need to get the picture.
Just he left it 30 years ago.
So
take the picture.
Harbor. Do we have a ship? Maybe.
If not, we'll find one of those too.
I could get some good shots here.
So do your thing, Bronto. And as soon as you take the first picture, the location of the second one will be marked. So let's head there. Okay, so we're in the bridge. Just take the picture and that's it.
Let me get this shot.
And now you can go ahead and report back to Viv. We're not going to do that quite yet because instead we're going to be completing more side quests. We can automatically complete a side quest with the professor's protege, and we can take a quest from Dave as well, and we can take on another hunt as well as finding another scraps of mystery. So head there and let's kill Prompto first because why not.
My hand slipped.
And here we are guys. First we need to deliver the slimy oil to the professor. She will tell you to go battle a Gigantoad, but you should have battled plenty of them by now, so you should have the slimy oil.
Howdy. Just heard word of another lost tag.
So you'll be able to complete that quest right away.
Ooh, you couldn't have come at a better time. Here's your next assignment. Make sure you hand it in like a good student.
Right, so we've battled plenty of Gigantoads. You should have battled one by now, and if you've been following my walkthrough, you probably battled quite a few of them already. So you should have the slimy oil. So just hand it over and that's it for this quest.
Back so soon? You're getting quicker at this. Good. Science waits for no man.
And now there's a few items for us to collect around these parts. And there's another Oracle Ascension coin that we can get. So I'm going to show you the location of the items. Plus there's a treasure very close by. Not that it's necessary for you to get it, but I still want to show that you can get it. So let's head over through
here.
Hopping around.
Come on.
On my way.
Seems Gladio was kind of pissed that Ignis there. And there's another item here. And now let's go through here. As you can see, there's always plenty of items for you to get as you go around. But now, fortunately, whenever we step inside a diner, it doesn't matter if we took or accepted a hunt on a different diner. We can always get the rewards regardless of the diner that we visit, and as such we can also accept another hunt here.
Welcome to the original Crow's Nest Diner, where it all began.
And now we're rank number 3, so we leveled up.
Congratulations on the promotion.
Yeah, I've never been so happy in my life. Anyway, let's accept another hunt. We're not going to complete it quite yet, but also remember that in order to find the dog tag, you should always talk to the diner owners. So now that you have the location of the dog tag on your map, you'll be able to go get it. But like I said, first we're going to get the scraps of mystery, and then we'll complete the hunt, and then we'll get the dog tag, and then we'll move on. So like I said guys, plenty of stuff for us to do during this segment, but by doing this we reduce the amount of trips that we have to take.
Well, if you're game, these feisty fiends are keen to play. It's all yours.
So keep that hunt marked, but now
there,
we're just going to get the Oracle Ascension coin. So if you go through here, let's head down, get out of my way, Gladio and everyone else. If you check this book, Ignis will learn another recipe, because he's always learning recipes, and I'm going to speed things up here. Yes, I know Noctis takes some damage from these big jumps, but I'd rather do this than to go down all the steps one by one. But here we go guys, we got the Oracle Ascension coin, and now there's the hunt, but we're not going to take it yet. Instead, we're going to travel to this area right over here, and that's where we will find scraps of mystery number 14. So drive there.
Everybody out.
Aye aye.
And you see that broken down car? That's where you will find the scraps of mystery. So jump down here. That fortress, in the next part we're going to visit it, and it's part of the main quest. We have to destroy the fortress, so keep that in mind as well. But here it is, scraps of mystery 14, and the location of this map is, it's inside the glacial grotto. You know, we've been there before a few parts ago, and we're going to go back there, not right now. Instead, we're going to complete the hunt first and then get the dog tag. They're both very close by. But that's where you need to head to, inside the glacial grotto. But we'll take care of that in a little bit. First, let's complete another hunt. And also head to that haven if you need to rest. But now we're going to get a move on, and remember, these enemies, they're weak against fire magic, so you can use fire aga against them, and if you get them all close together, you'll deliver a lot of damage to all of them.
Ready for this?
And aside from that, they're weak against shields, I believe, but I don't plan on using shields here. Instead, I'm just going to use Ignis Enhancement. Go.
Ignis!
And if you want,
this ought to give you an edge.
You can unleash Naughty's Limit Break. I prefer to call it Limit Break, it makes more sense to me. And just go wild. This will speed things up as well. Yeah, I most certainly kind of feel that I'm fighting this battle on my own, honestly.
Hi there, opening.
But I guess we'll let Prompto have some glory as well. So that's it. Another battle solved. Now we're going to go ahead and collect the dog tag, and we'll accept the rewards for this hunt once we head back to Lestalem. So we'll do that later. So that's our next destination, guys. Travel there. You can take your chocobo if you want. Alright. So let's get that dog tag. There's probably going to be some enemies nearby, but you shouldn't have any issues handling them. And it's so close by that I don't need to call my chocobo. So let's head through here.
On your guard.
We got company.
Let's do it, mister.
Honestly, they're all so close together that if you just want to fire a Blizzaga at them and get rid of them that way, you can. And you'll most likely get rid of all of them at the same time. So let's see how that works. Yep, that turned out pretty well. There we go. That's how you make quick work of them. But anyway, now let's get the dog tag. And we're not going to give it to Dave quite yet, since we're going to have to travel there during the main quest, the location where Dave is. We're going to make a pit stop there, mandatorily. We'll give the dog tag to him once we head back there. Instead, we're going to keep moving on. And we're going to head back to Lestalem now. Accept the rewards for a few side quests and start a new series of side quests. So first, let's talk to Viv or Hurley, because as you know, this guy looks like the dude from Lost, and you can't even say otherwise. I mean,
so,
maybe he was actually used as a model, who knows? I haven't seen him in any other TV series or anything like that, yeah, so I imagine he might need the extra money,
nice.
Maybe.
Real nice. I should be good now. It's all gonna work out. You see, I sort of shoved this feature down their throats, and now I'm on the hook for it. A couple of sloppy shots and I'd never hear the end of it.
So what are you? The editor or something?
Editor? I'm the president.
Huh?
President and CEO, Meteor Publishing Incorporated. What? Surprised?
Totally.
Guess I don't act too presidential. Anyway, now you know who I am. Let's keep working together, okay?
Okay. So another quest completed. Now let's talk to the arms vendor. And actually might as well accept the next quest as well, since we are going to complete it during this part too.
I'm still working on that feature about the old legend.
This hand bothers me
this
so much.
I need a photo of the royal tomb that lies in the Fall Grove.
Why do you need that?
Come on, you know why. There's a close link between the legends and the Lucian royal family. There's danger in them woods. You up for it?
Sure.
I was hoping you'd say that. Try to get a picture of the nearby gate as well. It's a good example of classic Lucian design and architecture.
Okay, we'll do that side quest once we start the side quest, essentially on the other side of Lestalem. Again, it's just better to get them done now, just to reduce the number of trips that we have to take.
You don't mind me taking pictures of the tombs?
Why would I?
So let's talk to the arms vendor next. And then we'll go back out and complete another series of side quests. I know, how exciting.
Hey,
to be fair, some of these side quests, they're not too bad. I mean, the side quests that involve, you know, getting vegetables or taking pictures, those are the really bad ones, in my opinion, because they're just so pointless. Side quests where you kind of have to go on hunts and so on, they're not as bad.
Hey, got another favor to ask whenever you can manage. Thanks in advance.
That's the last time we have to work for him, so there's that.
Scary to think that fortress is...
And we're going to start with that quest. We have to beat a bunch of enemies here, but after we do that we're going to get the map piece, but it makes sense to go there first and then take care of the map piece, so head in that direction. And before we do that, we're also going to get another reward for the hunt that we just completed. And accept another hunt as well. Now the next hunt that I'm going to accept, if you don't have Tandaga and your characters are underleveled, it might be a little bit hard to pull off, but assuming you've been following my walkthrough, you should be just fine, even though it's going to be a tough battle.
Recently these beasts have been prowling about.
So yeah, let's accept this one, because it's close by. He looks like such a creep, though.
Best of luck. Stay safe.
So, before we head there, like I said, we're going to complete the last quest for the arms vendor. Because as you can see, the other quests, they're all on the opposite side of the map. So here we are, guys. And there are three locations in which you need to defeat enemies here. Let's start with this first one.
The hunt is on.
Follow it up with a fire spell or a fire aga if you want. And you can get rid of all of them rather easily.
Nothing to it.
Okay. Next wave of enemies. And I apologize here, guys. I actually left the area. And you're supposed to beat more enemies here, so keep that in mind. So that's why you'll notice that it's a different day. It's not raining anymore.
Nothing to it.
But there's one more area for us to defeat enemies in, and then the quest will be completed.
Let's go.
So let's head there.
Nice riding with you.
They're weak against great swords and fire magic, and they're very weak, so you shouldn't have any issues defeating them at this point in the game. There we go. Okay, another quest completed. Oh, come on, give me a break.
Really? Again?
Ain't nobody got time for that. There we go. That's what they get.
Let's go.
Indeed.
You better run, that's right. Anyway, guys, here we are standing inside the glacial grotto or grotto. Anyway, I'm going to be cutting out all of the random battles because I faced all of these enemies before.
Not a fan of mushy desserts.
Instead, I'm going to just show you the location of the treasure. I do want to show myself traveling through the caverns because, as you know, finding these pieces of map, they're not easy to find at all. But just slide down here, going to be a bunch of imps. Get rid of them.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You shouldn't have any issues here. Now let's go through here.
We didn't come here for nothing.
Again.
And we could slide all the way down, even though Noctis will take damage if that happens. So instead, we'll go through here. And now let's keep going. We're going to have to battle more flans and imps, but they shouldn't be strong at this point. You should handle them very quickly. And now there's a bunch of imps for us to battle here before we can get to the map piece, but just get rid of them. You shouldn't have any issues. Like I said, use your daggers and you'll be fine.
Right.
Okay. So here's the location of the map piece, right over here.
And here's another one.
So it's right below the area where you need to kind of walk very slowly to cross to the other side. Once again, it's right over here. So make sure you get that. And now let's leave. Okay, guys, so before we advance, I'm going to unlock the spirit bonus boost. Make sure my characters have a higher spirit. And now set up camp here, and we're going to complete another hunt. So the hunt that we accepted previously, we're going to complete it now. Again, you just need to travel to the location that's marked on the map once you accept the hunt. So that's why I'm not showing myself traveling from point A to point B. But again, here is the location. And these dudes, they have a lot of health, so I think that each of them has maybe 60,000 something health. So they're tough. So a dual cast of Tandaga will really help things out here and make this fight a lot quicker. Especially because they're weak against him. And then as per usual, just using his enhancement and just strike away. Make sure you keep your distance. And be careful when they charge against you, because it's hard to block their attacks since sometimes you'll get the attack from different directions and you just won't be able to block all of his their attacks. Unleashing limit breaks here really works well to weaken them. And honestly, I know that my teammates are taking a lot of damage, but I wouldn't worry about them because they're going to be standing in the way regardless. So fire away with Tandaga. Because, like I said, that really speeds things up. And lightning combined with cheap mill, 99 units of that, you'll get dual cast Tandaga, which allows you to take care of these enemies much more quickly. You know, guys, you should have moved. No one's telling you to stay in the middle of the affected area. No one listens to Noctis, so what can I say?
You're up.
Oh, hi there, opening.
Okay. Oh, still alive. Impressive. Well, a few more strikes will do it. There we go. Blind strike. And I thought I would be able to block that attack. Apparently not. Oh well. It doesn't matter. We're going to finish it now. There we go. Alright. Now let's go and pick up some more vegetables, shall we?
Oh, glad that's over.
Let's go back and play video.
And if you check the name of this quest, it's almost like the creators actually mocking you for completing these side quests. I'm sure they know that these side quests are very dumb. But we're going to pick the vegging out side quest. So just drive there.
Do we have to walk?
But like I said, it makes sense for you to take care of these side quests in this order, because afterwards we'll be able to complete another photo op for Viv. We'll also be able to get information on a secret side quest, I guess, and we'll be able to complete
Knocked. Overhead.
An extra side quest as well, and then I promise we'll be done. I know this segment will be long, but hey, and I don't expect you to watch it from start to finish. I get it, I really do. But if you are looking for a specific side quest, just remember that on the timeline of my video descriptions, I always create a timeline where you can skip to all the key points of each video. So if you are looking for a specific side quest, then you can just do that. I promise I'm not offended if you do that. So anyway, let's drive there. And then we'll take care of that one as well. Okay guys, so here we need to take two pictures. And once you're done with the photo op, you can go inside the tomb and see if there's a royal arm inside. There won't be, and in order to get it we need to explore a dungeon. At this point we're not prepared to do that quite yet, but later on we'll do that. But you can avoid having to travel here later then. If you take care of this now. I totally forgot to equip a star pendant, but that's okay because the poison started to wear out in a little bit, so I'm not concerned. Where's the... Oh, there's one over there. It always annoys me how sometimes there's an enemy like that's stuck in between trees or something, and that messes up your time. But yeah, we're going to remain poisoned. I'm not going to give him an antidote, he just has to deal with it because it's going to wear out in a little bit. But we need to take two pictures here.
Now let's get the next one.
You can also get an amulet here behind the tomb, so make sure you get that. You'll see it on the map as a treasure.
How about from over here? Ready or not? Well, let's go and report in.
Not yet. Instead, we're going to go over through the back. And as you can see, it's been broken in. And I said I call this an amulet, but it's a talisman. So forgive me for my incorrection. But if you step inside, there's going to be a notice saying that the royal arm has been missing and the location of the royal arm. So yeah, we can't rely on the hunters to find it, obviously, because they're extremely incompetent, so it's up to Noctis. But like I said, we're not going to do that now, we'll save it for later. So don't worry about it right now. Instead, we're going to complete one final side quest before we're done with this segment. So again, we're just going to travel to the designated area.
When you're having fun.
Let's go.
Is that the delivery van?
Once again, we're going to have to battle a few enemies. But they're weak against pole arms. And remember, you can always equip a star pendant to avoid getting poisoned. But we'll get rid of them quickly, so we shouldn't have any issues here. We're more than over leveled at this point, honestly. Especially for these very basic side quests. There we go. Actually, I shouldn't have used value. I should have just executed the warp strike. That would have been faster. But there we go. Here's the cargo, guys. And if you want, you can go fishing. You can go and rest at the camp. But after you do that, head back to Lestalem and get your sweet rewards. So first, let's talk to Viv once again. He's going to give us another quest, but we're not going to complete it right now.
What's up? You made it back in one piece, but did you get the shots?
You tell me. Take a look.
Oh, baby, you got them all right. These are perfect. But man, you guys are tough. Surviving a place like that?
Nothing we aren't used to.
Used to it? What kind of journey are you kids on? Anyway, here's your reward. Next job I'm thinking is gonna be tricky, but I'll make it worth your while. You'll take a pay raise, I presume.
Hey, at least we're getting lots of gil for doing these side quests. Especially the photograph side quests.
If you really want to impress folks, you gotta show them something they've never seen before.
Sounds like a new job.
You got that right. I want a shot from atop the rock of Ravito.
Are you saying we're supposed to climb it?
That's exactly what I'm saying. They say there's a cave near the summit that offers the finest view in all of creation. This job requires camera skills and fighting skills, and no one's more qualified than you kids. Pull this off, and it'll be the most talked about photo in the history of my magazine. Good luck.
Yeah, I'm totally going to do it because of your magazine, not because I just want to make a complete walkthrough. But anyway, now that we've done that, we're going to talk to the arms vendor again. Get our rewards there, and then we're going to talk with the two salesmen, get our rewards, and that will be it for this segment.
Let's just make sure we get a good shot.
Hey, I've got it covered.
Noctis just collided against an invisible wall over there. But now let's head towards the arms vendor. There we go. And we can also accept a reward. Almost forgot to do that, actually. Accept a reward for the hunt that we completed too.
Thanks. Hey, what are you after this time?
As you can see, there's a drop in the prices of the weapons here, but you shouldn't really need anything at this point, so don't worry about it.
Hello.
Hello, creep.
Impressive work out there.
Yeah, that one wasn't easy, was it? I think it was the hardest stunt so far that I've done.
Would you like something to eat?
The way he stares at you, it just looks like he's going to kill you. And I'm going to accept this one. I don't know if I'll solve it right away or if I'll actually accept another hunt in Old Lestalem, but for now I'm just going to take it.
Stay safe.
And one final thing for us to do, guys. It's almost over, I promise. We're going to get the rewards for the other two quests that we completed. And fortunately, we won't have to do any more of them. This will be the last two. Let's start by talking to this guy.
Hey, I believe this is yours.
You're a lifesaver, brother. Bet you're curious what's inside.
Not really.
I'd tell you don't be a bore, but the contents ain't exactly riveting either. Just my usual. I'll make it cheap, though, so be sure to buy up.
Yeah, well, we knew that Noctis wouldn't care about the contents, and honestly, neither do I. It's just another side quest, even though it's not the worst side quest out there. There's a lot worse, like the vegging out side quest and the wild onions and so on. Those are much more boring in my opinion. But let's talk to the guy as well. And that's going to be it for this segment, my friends. In the next segment,
thanks again,
we're going
boys.
To
You're a great help.
Advance
you had a
with
hand in our veggies,
the
so try whatever you like.
Main story of the game. And we're going to drive Eris, and we're going to battle the Empire once again. So that's going to be fun. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all later.